PerfInsights can help you evaluate the health of your Azure SQL virtual machines, either in the portal or locally from the virtual machine. Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by David Pless, a program manager on the Azure Data Team. David, thanks so much for joining us again today.
Hello, Anna. Thanks for having me.
Always a pleasure. Now, in previous sessions of this series, we've talked about Azure storage and caching, monitoring, and the best practices for things like sizing and storage performance. Now, today, we want to examine how to properly evaluate the health of your VMs and troubleshoot various resource issues using something called PerfInsights. So without further preamble, David, can you tell us a little bit more about what PerfInsights is and how it can help us?
Sure. PerfInsights is a great tool for Azure Virtual Machines because not only does it do a great job of capturing and giving an evaluation of performance and diagnostic information, but it also summarizes system information, especially your storage information, making it a lot easier to figure out your Azure SQL Virtual Machine key performance characteristics. It gives you an overview of any environmental risks. It summarizes your storage configuration. It puts together in one place important diagnostic data that can be evaluated separately with familiar tools like such as performance analysis of logs. But PerfInsights RE really does a great job of analyzing the output. Now, there's a number of ways that PerfInsights can be executed. We have the ability to run PerfInsights from the Azure portal. We're going to take a look at that. And we have some deep insights that you can analyze as well. And this is going to be discovered by running PerfInsights from the command line, where you're going to have control over which scenarios you'll run PerfInsights under using several switches that are built into the toolset. So after the collection analysis is complete, you get a zipped output of all of the diagnostic data along with an HTML report that provides the analysis. So let's jump in and take a look. And let's start with the Azure portal. So as you can see, I'm on my VM blade here. I'm just on the overview. And what you're going to want to do to pull up PerfInsights in the portal is go to your diagnose and solve problems. And it's pulling up here. And then you're going to go to troubleshooting tools. And here's your performance diagnostics. So you can just click this. Now, this can take a while to run. I think by default it's 300 seconds. I like to do 600 seconds for some deeper analysis. But you can see that it actually is telling me the type of analysis that I've done. And then if I click on any one of these scenarios, I'm going to see the breakdown of the high impact, medium impact, and low impact. On this scenario, I have no high impact scenarios, but I have three medium and one low impact. So I click on this situation here. I can see a breakdown of my high CPU usage scenario. I even have a CLR in performance analysis, and then some information on speculative control settings that are enabled. If it saw SQL Server scenarios, any OS scenarios, these would all get populated with the high performance risk, medium, and then your informational low risk scenarios. Okay. Now, this is essentially taking the report and producing the output in the portal, so you can analyze it this way. If you want, you can always download the report, and then if you have another scenario, you can always run your own diagnostics. Now, I'm not going to go run the scenario, but I want to walk through a couple of the options. So if you click Run Diagnostics, you can see the potential analysis opportunities here. This is the quick performance analysis I mentioned. You can do a performance analysis, an advanced analysis, or your Azure file analysis. And then you can list your symptoms here. Like I could say a slow, let's say slow SQL VM, just so that is documented and listed. If you have a support request number, you can put this here. You just acknowledge that you're getting this information from Microsoft. And of course, read your privacy policy and so forth. And then if you've acknowledged everything, you can click OK, and that will run the diagnostic, everything in the background on your VM. You don't have to restart your VM or anything. It will just continue running and run this diagnostic for you. And then it will produce the report as you see in the portal. Now, this is in the portal. If you want to do a custom diagnostic on your machine, and we'll take a look at that now and see what that looks like. Now, I already have a report pulled up. If I wanted to run this, and if you see here, I'm going to go and let's just clear this out again so you can see how I got here. Okay, so I'm going to type perf insights list. And if you see, this is going to give me a very similar list that I saw in the portal. My quick, my benchmark, VM slow. This is a unique scenario, specifically at the command line. Azure files in advanced. And these are the scenarios that I mentioned earlier, xperf, network, storport tracing, performance counter trace, and then diskspeed benchmark if you like. And of course, here's some of the scenarios. So if I wanted to run a benchmark test for 600 seconds and accepting all of the disclaimer information, I could do it this way. Or this is my VM slow example. So I'm saying PerfInsights run VM slow, my duration of 600 seconds, 300 is the default. So these are just some example runs. Now, let's take a look at an actual report here. And right when you pull up the Perf Insights report, you're going to have findings, your run information, and your machine information. And then it breaks down all of the finding analysis information. So if I click SQL or high CPU or disk usage and so forth, I'm essentially going to be going directly to one of these tabs. Okay. So I'm going to kind of walk through a couple of these scenarios. So first of all, if you click run information, it tells you exactly the name of the machine, the command line scenario that you ran it under. It's going to give you a path to the log file information, which is really nice. That's your output information that you have for your perf insights capture. And then maybe some information about your machine itself. So it's kind of like a sys info track. Now, I did have some information on CPU. So let's click here. And then you can see how it's giving me a medium impact level, the finding, and the resources that are found. What's really nice is they're giving me references on how to address these scenarios right directly to Microsoft documentation. So in this way, it's like an assessment tool as well as a troubleshooting tool.
That's like awesome.
I love it. It's a really, and plus you're getting this updated information, and every time you run PerfInsights, it will give you an update, and then you can reanalyze. And of course, I like to be aware of any changes to the tool set. Right. And of course, here's all of your detailed impacted information based upon what was found in this particular workload. And of course, in my case, I was running a lot of heavy SQL scenarios, missing indexes, some statistic anomalies, some other scenarios that were going on. Maybe just some in general bad queries that were being run just to produce some workload for this particular scenario. Okay, and I can get my information on your speculation control settings and any of your top consumers, and it tells me the top consumers that were run, and it breaks this out this way. Okay, now there's a lot here. We're not going to be able to cover everything, so I really want to hone in on some really specific things that you want to take a look at. The other, let's take a look at memory. So even though that there's no findings that were an issue for memory, I really like to be aware of my top consumers, and it's telling me my working set. It's giving me information about what was committed, how much just is in use by your top memory consumers. So in this way, this is what I mean by it's a really good documentation tool as well. Even if it doesn't find an issue, it's going to give you some really good information. And that is especially true for storage. So I absolutely love what they're doing for storage. And I want to spend a little bit of time here. Now, we did have an issue that was found in storage. I was throwing a lot of workload at this guy. So it's breaking down. I had some demo workloads running. Of course, SQL is going to take quite a bit. If you can see, I was doing some query store scenarios here. And a bunch of OSTRS, and that was those OSTRS routines were doing some like scenarios where I had some missing indexes, really big table scans, just some bad query patterns and scenarios that I knew that were gonna produce some heavy workloads. But in this findings, I'm gonna go backwards. I want to start at the high resolution disk usage. If you remember from the previous sessions that we've done, we've been talking quite a bit about IOPS and throughput. So these high resolution disk rules, these CSV files, have the information about the historical disk usage. And it's balancing this against our premium storage. So it's giving me just based upon the usage from a P4 to a P60. And I'm going to take the queue depth stuff out, so we can only look directly at our IOPS. And if you see here, this is my P60 is this top line. Right. This is going to be my P40, my P50. I see a spike here that goes past my P40, P50. But I can see that most of my workload, that pink line, that would be my P30. I can see most of my workloads are well underneath that. So if you're looking for your specific disk needs based upon your IOP and throughput, we've been talking about this quite a bit in previous sessions. PerfInsights is the tool specifically to give you that and to graph it out for you. Now, this might be my favorite aspect of what PerfInsights gives us from a SQL perspective, because you know how much we really care about IOPS and throughput. This is my IOPS. I can do the exact same thing for throughput. The only thing I will tell you is I recommend removing the queue depth pieces, as you can see that, you know, I'm doing as I'm talking through this, just because it provides a little bit of clarity. So you can just specifically look at only your throughput scenarios, and you can see the same scenario here. Here's my throughput. Here's my top disk, that top disk being my P60. And you can see here that I'm well underneath that pink line. That pink line again is my P30. So that's true for both IOPS and throughput. I know that for the most part, other than that spike, I'm well below those scenarios for both IOPS and throughput if I chose a P30 disk for that.
Right.
So really strong capability here, but you know, there's a lot more here too. So I can get my disk consumer information. What were my high disk usage periods? What was being used? SQL Server, my demo workloads, my reads, my writes, how much data between reads and writes, when did this happen? What disks were specifically hit? What were the average IOPS throughput reads, writes for each of those disks? And then I can get, and I'm gonna move past some of these other things because I wanna focus on some key things here. Here, to me, this is huge from a documentation perspective. The fact that I can go to the storage pool here and it's telling me specifically the disks that I have, how the number of columns in each storage pool, and remember, this is going to match the number of disks or the number of devices in Azure for your virtual machine templates. That's the best practice from a VM perspective. That's what we would want. It's telling me I have a 64K interleave. Otherwise, I would have to dig through PowerShell, through the system information to get that. I'm getting it all here in the PerfInsights documentation. I also can see how my volume is mapped out, telling me the number of disks, the physical disk name, also giving me my interleave here as well, but it's letting me know what my OS disk is, what my temporary disk is, the volume ID and labels for each of my disks. So I can see, you know, how those are being laid out and used. And then of course, my disk map specifically on the physical disk name and its ID, if I want to look at it at that level. So this is, it's really nice. Oh, and Anna, I can't forget host caching, it would have been terrible if I had missed this. Host caching, letting me know which disks are set to read only, which ones are set to none. And remember, data disks should be read only. Your transaction log should be set to none. And for SQL files, we don't want it to be read write for any scenario. I can confirm that here. I can confirm that in the portal, but it's really nice to be able to run a report and get that information. And of course, you know, if there's any network issues, Windows issues, they're gonna let me know here. You know, that was that low finding on my information. The key thing here is our SQL scenarios. And of course, I ran a lot of workload, a lot of scenarios. It's giving me a list of the impact level, which would affect performance. Low is going to be informational. Medium is those best practice scenarios that you would be looking at. But all of these recommendations, whether I break these out or not, are going to be, that gives you your details, are going to point to where our documentation that we've been talking about this whole time and all of these data exposed scenarios that we've been covering over the past several months. And it's absolutely great that it's all in one place for you. That's what I love so much about PerfInsights.
Awesome. I mean, this has been a really thorough demo. I really enjoyed kind of getting the walkthroughs, and I like how you can get kind of the same experience in the portal as you get in the you know, kind of more local type of environment. As we close out, do you have any final tips for folks that are just getting started with PerfInsights?
Well, it's really easy. Just go out, download the tool if you want to use it on the local machine. They give you some advice on what switches to look at. The scenario of VM slow or quick insights, that's going to be kind of a lesser impactful scenario. Definitely wouldn't run the heavy benchmarks or advanced workload on a production virtual machine. Also, leverage the portal, and you can start from there from like your quick win scenario. Make sure you you're using your latest versions, because we're certainly putting in more capabilities, and it's an evolving tool.
Awesome. Cool. David, thanks so much for joining us today. This has been really useful. I learned a lot. I got to see a lot. I have some resources to go check out. But for our viewers, we also put those resources in the description, so be sure to check those out. David, again, thanks so much for joining us today. For our viewers, if you like this video, go ahead, give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.